What's good, my YouTube family? This is your boy JC, and I'm so happy to have you guys back again for another video. What I got before you today is a FireCuda 530 M.2 SSD. This one is a 500 gigabyte. That's all I could afford at this time, because everything is sponsored out of my pocket. As you can see, this says works with compatible AFC PS5. And this one in particular comes with a heatsink, which is very needed nowadays, because sometimes you can't find them cheap ones on Amazon or Walmart or eBay. But this is a very good addition to have. Like I said, I'm just going to do a quick unboxing, and at the end of the video I'm going to use my thermal gun to scan to see how to see the temperature after I run it for at least 15-20 minutes. So we all know how this works, so we're just going to go right into it right away. Alright, so I'm just going to try to gently open this box real quick. I don't like to rip things apart. If it gets on my nerves, I'm just gonna have to do the rippity rip. And I thank you guys for subscribing to the channel. You're helping it to grow, and I really appreciate it. And the more you guys subscribe and the more channel grow, the more I can get to go and get more things that you guys want to see. All right so don't forget to leave your comments so I know what you're thinking, what you want me to unbox or get to review, and I'll be more than happy to do it for you guys. Apparently this is kind of trolling me right now, so I'm not gonna do the nice boy stuff no more. I'm just gonna rip it. I'm trying to be cute with it. Trying to be cute with it, but you can't be cute sometimes. Sometimes you just gotta take it by force. That thing that jumped out on the gun. All right, so as you can see right here in the packaging, oh, this comes a lot. Okay, the FireCuda comes with some troll stickers. You see the FireCuda Gaming troll stickers. Pretty cool. Comes with some more troll stickers right here with Seagate Gaming FireCuda, and it comes with a nice little booklet right here with your rescue data recovery service. And then it comes with some more booklets, and you already know the deal. Let's put it to the side. Comes with a little foam to keep it in place. I really care much about that. Now this is what everybody wants to see. Well, let's first read the caution. What the caution says: contents subject to damage by static electricity. Do not open. Handle with care. All right, I hear loud and clear. So easy. That's it. Let's look at it right here in all its glory. Oh, dang, this feels nice. This is the FireCuda 530 with the heatsink. Because if you look in my playlist, I did a FireCuda before, but I never did it with a heatsink. This is very nice. It got a nice little weight to it. It's a little bit weighty and it's cool. As you can see right here, you got a nice thermal padding. This is a very good thermal padding. It's very thick, and it looks like, I don't think it's foam like the Acer Predator, but other than that, it's very well built. It's very well built, very heavy. And it's nice metal feeling. You got a nice metallic feel. It's very smooth to the touch. You can see the nice little orange lining right here. And with the little logo right here, that's pretty cool. So again, from the other side, the thick thermal padding, so that should provide optimum cooling. You got four screws, two on each side, and this is a 2280. All right, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna throw this bad boy into the PlayStation 5. I'm gonna show you, that it fits perfectly inside. Then we're gonna do the upload speed test. All right, everybody, we're back, and you can see it's of the FireCuda with the heatsink installed in the PlayStation 5. I have the digital edition. You can see how flush it is right there. How flush it is. Get a bit of angle. Perfectly, right on the line. So Seagate got the dimensions right on the money. See, just a little bit of space. Not much to play with right here. See, it's very flush. Perfect. So let me just put this like a plate on. And see, not an itch. It fits perfectly. And let me emphasize the word again, perfectly. So I'm just gonna screw this up. I'm gonna do the formatting, and then do some upload speed tests. All right. And I'm tired. I've been working all day. All right, let's get into it. All right, my friends, we're back. We're on the main screen. I already formatted, and I got a speed of 657 megabits for the read, So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to go into settings and I'm going to download my games that I always use to do my testing. And these games is in no particular order. So let me go into console. And if you guys watch my videos, you know what I'm going to select. And if you're new to my channel, these are the games I'm going to select. These are the games I choose. Let me just go do this real quick. The games I use is God of War, Marvel Spider-Man, Red Dead, and Miles Morales. So I'm going to move them all over to the FireCuda 530 with heatsink. And then as soon as it's complete, then we're going to go into the testing. All right. So stay with me. All right, everybody. This is the most exciting part of my uploading test speed test that I love so much. This one is when I'm going to do the upload with just the FireCuda by itself. And then it's going to be the FireCuda against the PS5 console storage. And then quite possibly, maybe with the Western Digital Black as well. All right. I'm so excited. I can't wait. All right, let's do this. All right, this is the part of my conclusion of the video. Like all this internal SSD have a heatsink. I'm gonna scan it with my thermal laser and see what's the temperature. because it's been in the PlayStation 5 for like 30 minutes. So let's see what we got here. Shoot it. Keep it steady. Run. Keep going, I'm trying to keep it steady. Oh no, approximately 32 degrees. It's not that bad. So, let me just wrap it up. In conclusion, I really like it. It's a very capable internal SSD. I had it before, but with the heatsink, make it so much better. The thing I like about it, I like the way it's structured, it's well built, and it's got some weight to it. It's got a very thick thermal padding in the middle, and the heatsink will protect this internal for a long time. So Seagate did a very good job. It performs pretty well, and I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. So if you guys really do, you already know what to do. Just go ahead and subscribe. Help me to get to 1,200 subscribers. Share it, like it, so it can be noticed in the YouTube system. Thank you guys again, and I'll see you in the next one. And also, don't forget, I got another one coming. And it's going to be with this one right here. The T4's Carder A440. So don't miss that video, alright? Thanks again. I'll see you in the next one.